Now, let's talk about the Elon Musk-Donald Trump interview. It went for 2 hours. But the media, I've got to say, were not impressed. USA Today are amongst the media slamming it. They called it an unmitigated disaster between, listen to this, a right-wing loon and a fascism-curious billionaire. They also said he was rambling, babbling on about crowd sizes and immigration and President Joe Biden and whatever else seemed to pass through his mind, and just a whole lot of other nonsense. But the numbers don't lie. The number of people who've listened to that interview, who have heard parts of it or all of it, is enormous. I think by any measure, it was an enormous success if you want to get your message across.
Well, exactly. And, you know, one of the key parts of a democracy is for candidates to engage in open form discussion. I mean, a 2-hour discussion, Trump will routinely do rallies that are 1-2+ hours. Whether you like him or not, the reality is that he's probably been one of the most open and transparent presidential candidates we've seen. And we need to have more of these long form debates and discussions, not less. I mean, Kamala Harris won't even front a 10-minute interview, let alone do a 2-hour sit down. So, you know, which one is better for democracy?
Well, absolutely. And the fact that so many topics were discussed in a very casual manner with two people speaking, I think it just gave a great insight into where that candidate stood on a range of issues. And that's what you want as a voter. You want to know what the candidate is going to do in office. Now, just before he left for yet another holiday, President Joe Biden, remember him, he sat down with CBS and he again pushed that lie about President Donald Trump calling white supremacists in Charlottesville very fine people.
It's a consequence of those neo-Nazis and white supremacists come out of the fields in America with torches, carrying Nazi banners. Press went to the then President Trump and said, what do you think? He said, they're very fine people on both sides. And I knew then, I knew I'd do something. And that's when I decided to run.
I cannot believe we are still hearing this absolute lie that has been debunked over and over again, because the whole thing's on video. We're still hearing it. And there was no pushback from that interview. In fact, he reinforced that lie. It's a hoax and a lie. Even the left-wing Snopes, the fact-checking side, has belatedly acknowledged it's a lie. And let's go to the tape, because this is what President Trump actually said.
And you had people, and I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally. But you had many people in that group other than neo-Nazis and white nationalists, okay?
They should be condemned totally. So he was talking about the people who were at that protest because they didn't want a statue to come down. I would argue those people on the right side of history, and there were very fine people amongst them, they're not the neo-Nazis. That's like pretending that the Women's March in Melbourne were all neo-Nazis because a bunch of idiots turned up and gate-crashed their protest. I can't believe this lie is still got currency now in 2024.
Well, exactly. And when you actually look at the whole clip, it's Trump said the exact opposite. The exact opposite of what they accuse him of. I think that the hope that we do have is with social media, with Twitter and with others, this is actually being uncovered. You know, 20 or 30 years ago, we never would have known that this was all a hoax and this was all a lie. But the reality is, I think more and more people, particularly what happened in COVID and other things, a lot more people are beginning to realise that the mainstream media is not always what it seems.